Well, you'll be excited to know that we have another volcano-related question, this time about the South Island from Seb. So he'd like to know, is the Banks Peninsula volcano going to erupt again? And there's a second half to his question, which is when the Alpine Fault goes, how strong will the earthquake be felt here? And how will it feel in comparison to the 2010-2011 quakes that they experienced? So Tom, your chance to talk about South Island volcanoes. And Caroline, maybe you could talk about the shaking experience as well in Christchurch and how an Alpine Fault earthquake might feel in comparison to that.
Right, thanks, Jenny. So great question. So the on Banks Peninsula, which is very, very close to Christchurch, part of Christchurch City is actually built on Banks Peninsula. It's a series of three or four old volcanoes, which geologists believe are extinct. And what we mean by extinct is that they won't erupt again. So the volcanoes there are around about 11 to 6 million years old and very much stopped erupting 6 million years ago. What's interesting about them, and especially during the Canterbury earthquake sequence, is there's these hot springs that are present throughout the Banks Peninsula. And so when we had the Canterbury earthquake sequence, it energized some of those springs and there was increased hot water flow coming out of many of them, which was easy to assume that maybe there was some renewed volcanic activity. But what those hot springs are driven by is actually connections down to the geothermal gradient underneath the Canterbury Plains, and it's fault-related fluids that are coming back up and being present at the surface and not magmatic related or anything to do with magma there. So unfortunately for people like me, Christchurch doesn't have active volcanoes. They're very much extinct as far as we can tell.
Thanks, Tom. I'll jump to the next question, which I think was about ground shaking and also how it would be experienced in Christchurch specifically. So from the Alpine Fault. So ground shaking is really controlled, by how big is the earthquake, so the magnitude of the earthquake, but it's also controlled by how close you are to that earthquake, to the fault. And there's another factor, which is how soft the ground you're standing on is. So this is called the site amplification. And we have Liam here is an expert. And so these are the three factors. For the Alpine Fault, so back to Christchurch. Christchurch is about 100 kilometers away from the Alpine Fault, at least 100 kilometers away. And so we would expect a moderate level of shaking if we were accounting for the presence of the Canterbury Plains. So unfortunately, the plains will add a lot of amplification to the ground shaking experienced in Christchurch. And so to just relate back to what the Canterbury earthquake sequence was, this would be, in part of the region, this would be similar to what's been experienced in the Duffield earthquake. Now, I just forgot to say, one main difference would be because of the sheer size of the Alpine Fault, so we're talking 500 kilometer long fault, the rupture, so how long the rupture takes to unzip will be at least 3 minutes. So this is something that we haven't experienced in modern time in New Zealand yet. This would be an extremely long rupturing of the fault. So this adds to the duration of ground shaking. Now that said, we don't really know what the next magnitude 8 plus Alpine Fault will look like. And so about 6 months ago, a team of Victoria scientists and myself, told you I loved instruments, we went out to the West Coast and we installed more than 50 of those very sensitive sensors, densely spaced along the fault. And the idea was to listen, so not to volcanoes, sorry, but to listen to tiny earthquakes on the fault, because the fault looks quiet, but it's humming in the background. And we're really trying to listen to the Alpine Fault to tell us how it's behaving right now in order to predict how it's going to behave in the next earthquake. So there's a lot of uncertainty in what the ground shaking will be, and there's just more and more science coming through to better constrain what the next earthquake might be like. So I'm going to stop here, otherwise I could talk for a long time again.